Welcome back. We're going to be doing yoga to let go and let loose today. I did a similar practice in my Miscellaneous March series. So it'll be similar but different. We're going to start in turtle shell pose today. So bring your feet together like you would in butterfly pose and then push them out. From here, see if you can bring one arm under one leg and one arm under the other. Zoe, be quiet. Thank you. You want to naturally round through the spine and just let the head hang heavy. We're going to take three deep breaths here, becoming present on our mat, leaving our stresses off of the mat during our practice. You're going to inhale to a four count through the nose and exhale to an eight count through the mouth. We're going to do that three times. Let's take a deep inhale. And exhale. Walk it over to the right.
Let the head hang here. Take a deep breath.
Come through center and over to the left.
Take a deep breath.
And back through center. Walk those fingertips up. We're going to bring the feet in now, coming into butterfly pose. Let the knees fall open, sitting up nice and tall. We're going to twist over to the right, keep the spine long, look over that shoulder. Take a deep breath here. And come on over to the left. Right leg comes out long, left foot comes on the inside of that thigh, flex that right foot. Grab that toe with two or three fingers, open up the torso, stretch the left arm over left ear. Take a deep breath here. And come on up, let's switch sides. Left leg comes out, right foot comes on the inside of that thigh. Sitting up tall, grab that toe with two or three fingers, open up the torso. Right arm stretches over right ear. Make sure you're not sinking through the torso, open it up. Take a deep breath here. And now we're gonna come into a full middle split. Don't overdo it because we're just starting out, we're just warming up the body. The booty. Make sure you're not rolling back. If you're like this, help. Bring your legs in. We're going to grab both toes. If that's not an option for you, you can grab the shins or you can place fingertips on the ground in front of both legs. From here, we're going to just melt the chest forward and keep the neck in line with the spine. Take an inhale and an exhale. Big inhale and exhale. One more time. Slowly roll it up. Bring the right arm out. Hook the left arm around. Pull it in towards your chest. Look over that shoulder. Take a deep breath. And now the other other side, left arm, hook the right arm around it, pull it in towards your chest, look over that shoulder, deep breath, and release. Grab the four fingers on the right hand, pull them underneath, and over. Fingers under and over. Interlace the fingers, bring them out. We're going to reach them overhead, relax the shoulders, and bring them in front. Push out, chin to chest. Lift them up, relax the shoulders. Take an inhale here. And then exhale, bring them down, chin to chest. Reach them over, inhale. And exhale, chin to chest. And release. Let's come into a tabletop. Knees come under the hips. Hands directly under the shoulders, widen those fingers. From here, we're gonna bend through the elbows, melt that chest forward. Just doing some body circles. And then reverse. You can freestyle with it here, just whatever feels good. Cows and get that spine warmed up. We're going to open up through the chest, shoulders roll open, lift the chin, inhale, exhale, round through,
chin to chest, pushing through the tops of the feet and the hands.
We're going to inhale, open,
exhale, round through,
inhale to open.
Exhale, round it through.
Come back to a neutral spine. Lift the belly button towards your spine to engage through the core. We're going to bring the right leg out. The ball of the foot is on the mat. Push back with that heel. We're going to do some rainbow kicks. Tap the toe on the other side of that left leg and then bring it over. Tap the toe. Just making like a U formation or a rainbow formation as we breathe. And really using that glute to lift the leg. Bring it in. Bring that left leg out now. Onto the ball of that foot, push back with that heel. And rainbow kicks on the other side. Bring it over that right leg and back. Use that glute to lift without holding your breath.
Left foot crosses We're going to lift up to the tippy toes and sink the heels down. Lift up and sink. Lift up and sink. On your next inhale, bring that right leg high, three-legged dog. We're going to exhale, bend the knee, bring the heel towards the glute, open up that hip, keep the shoulders square to the mat, the front of the mat. Deep inhale here. We're going to exhale, come through the center, tap three times. Lift that knee to chest. Come back to your three-legged dog. Inhale here. Exhale, bend the knee, heel to glute, open up that hip. Big inhale here. We're going to exhale, tap three times. Come on back up. Three-legged dog. Inhale. Exhale. Bend that knee. Heel to glute. Take a big inhale here. We're going to exhale. Bring the knee to chest. Step it up between those hands. Drop down that back foot. Squeeze the inner thighs to lift up. Reach the arms overhead. Coming into steeple grip or Charlie's Angels fingers. Relax the shoulders away from the ears. Sink into that front hip and look up towards the sky. Take an inhale and exhale. Big inhale and exhale one more time. Gently release. Frame that front foot, hop up on the back foot. Slide that leg back. Coming into your high plank. Drop your knees if you need a modification for your chaturanga. Inhale to come forward. Exhale, lower. Open it up. Deep breath in. We're going to exhale, turn, look over that right shoulder. Come back through center, upward facing dog. Inhale. We're going to exhale, turn. Over that left shoulder. Come on back. Gently lower down to your belly. From here, we're going to engage through the core. And we're going to lift the chest, the arms, and the legs all at once. Let's take a deep breath in. Exhale, lift up. Lotus. And lower. Take a deep breath in. Engage through the core. Exhale, lift. Lower down. Bring the hands under the shoulders. Curl the toes. Come back to tabletop and then down dog. Take a moment. Stretch through the backs of those legs. Take three breaths. Take your vinyasa. Use your knees if you need.
center. This time, we bring knees as wide as the mat. Big toes touch. Sit back on those heels. Find a comfortable position in your extended child's pose. So if you find that when you go to put your head on the mat, that your glutes are lifting from your heels, I want you to work on planting the glutes on the heels, opening up through the hips, and utilize your block so that you're keeping your neck in line with the spine. As your hips begin to open up, take some deep breaths. Feel free to utilize any breaths that we've been practicing in my more recent practices, like Ujjayi breath, breathing with a slight restriction in the throat, keeping the mouth closed with the exhale, or Bee's breath. You can do whatever breath you like, whatever breath is easiest for you. For me, Ujjayi breath is the easiest one. Okay, let's come on back to our tabletop. Curl the toes, come back to your down dog. Lift the hips. Take three breaths here. Maybe practice with your Ujjayi breath or the Darth Vader sounding breath. On your next inhale, bring the right leg high to three-legged dog. We're going to exhale. This time, step it wide. Bringing that foot halfway on, halfway off of the mat. Drop down on the back leg. Walk those hands out and drop down to your forearms. Maybe you roll onto the outside and that right foot opening up through the hip and hip flexors. Take a deep breath here. One more deep breath. Maybe on your last breath, you use that hand to push out and open up that hip a little more. Maybe even looking up to the sky. Big inhale and exhale. Bring that foot back. We're going to walk up on those hands. And from here, we're going to lift that back leg. Come on up to your fingertips. Reach around with that right arm and see if you can grab that foot. If that's not in your practice, just keep that foot lifted and reach around and maybe look back at the thumb. If you are able to reach it, you can come onto your hand now and sink forward. Looking back towards those toes, take an inhale and an exhale. Inhale. And exhale. One more inhale. And exhale. Drop that leg down. We're going to twist the right arm open to the sky. Inhale here. And exhale. Thread the needle under that left arm. Inhale. Open up to the sky. Exhale. Thread the needle. Inhale to open. And exhale, thread the needle. Come on back. Place your hands on the mat. Pop up on that back leg. We're going to slide that leg right into your plank. Drop your knees if you need assistance in your chaturanga. Deep breath in. Exhale, lower. Open it up. Inhale here, upward facing dog. Exhale, look over the right shoulder. Inhale to come back. Exhale, look over that shoulder. Drop the knees down. Curl the toes. Come back to your down dog. Take three breaths. Relax the shoulders away from the ears. Next inhale, left leg comes high. 7 wide, foot half on, half off of the mat. Drop down on that back leg, flatten that foot. Walk the hands out. Drop down to your forearms. Roll onto the outside of that left foot. Take an inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. On your last breath, use that left hand to push on the out inside of that inner thigh. Opening up that hip. Big inhale. And exhale. And bring that foot back. We're going to walk those hands in. Lift that back leg. Reach around the left arm. Maybe you stay here and just look back at that thumb. Or maybe you grab the toes and sink forward. Looking back at the toes in your hand. Take a deep breath. One more deep breath. Last one. Gently release. From here, we're going to reach that left arm up into the sky as we inhale. And exhale, thread the needle under that arm. Inhale, twist open. Exhale, thread the needle. Big inhale, open. And exhale, thread the needle. Come on back, hop up on that back leg, slide that leg back, come into your plank. Take your vinyasa here, use the knees if you need. Big inhale, keep those shoulders from sinking. Do not sink through those shoulders. Inhale, exhale, open it up. Big inhale here. We're going to exhale. Look over that right shoulder. Come on back. Inhale. And exhale. Look over that left shoulder. Make sure you're not sinking here either. Keep those shoulders away from your ears. Drop down on those knees. Curl the toes under and lift the hips. Come into your down dog. We're going to step the right foot up behind the right hand and the left foot behind the left hand. Bringing the feet close to the edge of the mat. Slight turn out in both feet. Sinking that tailbone towards the mat. Coming into Malasana or yogic squat. Don't worry if your heels lift off of the mat, that's fine. Take an inhale. And an exhale. Inhale. And exhale. One more time. We're going to walk the hands out and twist the right arm open to the sky. Bind it behind your back. And let's take it to the other side. Twist the left arm open to the sky. Bind it behind your back. On back. Walk the fingertips in, straighten through the legs, heel, toe, those feet, hip width distance, coming into your forward fold. Gentle bend in the knees, melting that torso, tailbone reaching for the sky. Big inhale here, and exhale. We're going to slowly roll up one vertebrae at a time. Big inhale, reach the arms overhead. And exhale, hands to heart. From here, we're just going to do some hip circles. So really bending through the knees. Don't worry how you look. I used to hate this in yoga class because I'm like, oh my god, everybody's looking at me. Nobody cares. They don't care. I promise you that. If you need a little bit wider of a stance, that's fine. You'd be surprised how tight your hips are when doing hip circles. And reverse. Make sure you're breathing. extends it out wider, bring it in under the hips, coming into Tadasana, standing up nice and tall. Tucking that pelvis under slightly, keeping those legs active by lifting the kneecaps. Ribs open up, chest opens up, core is engaged. Relax through the shoulders. We're going to bring the weight into the left foot, hands to heart. Right knee lifts. Use that quad to lift that leg as you inhale. We're going to exhale. Bring it around. Start squaring the hips towards the mat. Coming into your warrior three. See if you can reach the hands in front. Charlie's Angels fingers. And gently drop in to your warrior one. Open up through that chest. Really utilizing the outside of that back foot. And exhale, let's heel toe it a little wider. Coming into your warrior two. Torso facing the side of the mat now. Arms come out. Relax through the shoulders. We're going to reach in front. Come into your peaceful warrior. And let's bind that right arm around our back. Maybe you can grab a hold of that front thigh. Take an inhale here. And exhale, straighten through that front leg. We're going to reach forward. Tip into triangle. Open that chest. Big inhale and exhale. From here, we're going to come back into extended triangle. Big inhale. We're going to exhale right back into triangle. Inhale to extend it. Exhale to triangle. One more time. Big inhale, and exhale. Let's turn, bending on that front leg, turn on the ball of the back leg, foot, and we're going to just bend that back leg too, and push off, stepping up a little bit closer, small turnout in that back foot, front foot facing forward. Coming into pyramid pose. Take an inhale, nose to knee. And exhale. Big inhale. And exhale. One more inhale. And exhale. We're going to slowly begin to bend through that front leg. Walk those fingertips forward. Lift that back leg. Find a flat back. When you feel steady, bring hands to heart, and maybe Charlie's Angels fingers, and step it up, shake it out. Whew. Sometimes that leg just wants to give out on you, right? Standing up, nice and tall, coming back into our Tadasana or mountain pose. Feeling like a warrior goddess, standing up tall, nice long neck, nice straight spine, shoulders are open. Let's bring the weight into the right foot as we bring hands to heart. Lifting that left knee. Use that quad to lift that leg. We're going to bring it around to the side. Begin squaring the hips to the mat. Coming into your warrior three. Bring those fingers out, Charlie's Angels fingers, look forward. Tip into warrior one, open up through that chest. Big inhale and exhale. Let's heel toe into our warrior two. Reach front. Bind that left hand behind that back. Come into your peaceful warrior. Big inhale. We're going to straighten through that front leg. Slowly turn, frame that front foot, bend on that front leg, come onto the ball of the back foot. We're gonna push off, step it up a little closer. Back foot is slightly turned out, front foot is not. Facing the front of the mat. Bringing nose to knee in pyramid pose. We inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Let's walk those fingertips forward. Lift that back leg. Find a flat back. Once you feel steady, hands to heart. Look forward, Charlie's Angels fingers. And step it up. Shake it out. Reach the arms overhead. Big inhale, exhale, dive it down the middle. Coming into halfway lift, hands on the thighs. Nice long spine, nice flat back. Big inhale. And exhale to forward fold. Hands on the mat, step it back. Drop your knees down, swing the legs around. And let's slowly lay back, one vertebrae at a time. Go ahead and tuck the hands under the glutes. We're gonna lift both legs. Take a big inhale and exhale. We're gonna drop the legs down, draw your circle, and come back up. Big inhale, exhale to drop, open it up, come on back to the top. Repeat as you breathe. One more. Hug it in. Again, let's bring the hands underneath the glutes slightly. Legs come up. Drop them down halfway and scissor. Drop them down almost to the ground and lift up. We're going to repeat that four more times. Big inhale, drop halfway, exhale, scissor. Drop them down almost to the ground and lift up. Two more just like that. You've got this. Don't give up. Fill those lungs with oxygen. Drop them down. Almost to the ground and lift up. One more time. Fill those lungs with oxygen. Drop. Drop. Lift and hug it in. Woo! My abs are on fire.
shoulder blades on the mat. Take a deep breath. And release. Come on back. Now, everyone, you can either do two things. You can either, one of two things. Turn to your right side in fetal position and come into a seat that way. Or we're going to rock and roll by crossing our ankles, grabbing our big toes, reaching those over our head, and giving ourselves momentum using the core. So do that a couple times until you come into a seat. Come on back to your middle split. Now, again, you can either bring your fingertips to the ground or your shins or grab your big toes. We're going to melt that chest forward. Take a couple breaths here. Feel free to use Ujjayi breath or V's breath.
Practicing with me today. I hope you enjoyed today's practice, and I hope to see you back tomorrow for a new practice. Have a great rest of your day. Namaste.